Hi guys, I'm Srishti. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you're doing well. In today's video, I'm going to bake some brownies and I thought I would share this recipe with y'all because it's super yummy, super easy and super fun to make and you and your family or friends would love it. So let's go. For the brownies that we are making today, you will need maida, powdered sugar, you can also use caster sugar, baking powder, cocoa powder, dark chocolate, 2 eggs and some butter. So let's get into the recipe. First, I'm going to roughly chop the dark chocolate. You can use any dark chocolate that you want. I'm using Amul's dark chocolate. I usually use the Mordei's dark chocolate, but I couldn't find it in the market. Now I'll take a saucepan and I'm going to melt this dark chocolate with some butter. So I just cut the butter into few pieces and I'm going to throw it into the saucepan along with the dark chocolate. Make sure you keep stirring the chocolate butter mixture or else the chocolate would get burnt and it won't taste that good. So keep continuously stirring the mixture. Don't forget to use salted butter, because if you use salted butter, the salt in the butter just brings out the taste of the chocolate and it tastes more amazing. But you can also use normal, regular, unsalted butter, but don't forget to add a pinch of salt to it. It would taste delicious. And we're done. So I'm going to keep this aside. I've kept the butter chocolate mixture aside and I'm going to take the sugar, add the eggs. You can double the ingredients if you want to make a bigger batch, but today I'm just making one pan full of brownies. You can also do the eggless recipe by using hung curd or Greek yogurt. Don't use homemade curd because it has lots of water in it and we don't want that excess water. Now to the egg and sugar mixture, I am going to add our butter and chocolate. I am going to mix it again, but I am not going to use the machine. I am going to use my hands to gently fold in the two wet ingredients. Our wet ingredients are all done. Now we are going to move to the dry ingredients. Now for the dry ingredients, you'll be needing maida. Into the all-purpose flour, I'm going to add 3 tablespoons of cocoa powder and 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder. Now I'm going to mix them. Now I've mixed all the dry ingredients. Now we're going to fold the wet ingredients into the dry ingredients. Add the wet ingredients batch by batch and not everything at one time. Before we mix all the ingredients, don't forget to preheat your oven at 180 degrees Celsius. While your oven is preheating, don't forget to oil the pan and line it with parchment paper so that your brownies don't stick to the pan and it easily comes off. Now we are going to add in our batter. Brownie batter is supposed to be thick and gooey. I'm going to quickly chop some almonds and put it on our brownies. You can also add walnuts if you want. My oven is a convection oven, so it doesn't take a lot of time for baking, but you need to check with your oven whether it's a convection oven or a normal oven. And I will pop this into the oven for around 4 to 5 minutes. So we're done with baking our brownies and now we are waiting for the brownies to cool down. Don't cut your brownies right after you have baked them because they'll tend to break because they are hot, and let them take a proper form, and the butter that we put in the batter, it takes time to settle and take a shape, so don't cut it right away. And also don't forget to eat these brownies with vanilla or chocolate ice cream. They taste amazing with it. Also, you can top it off with some sea salt if you like sea salt with it. And yeah.
2 moments later.
Perfect brownie! Thank you so much you guys for watching this video. I hope you try this recipe at your home and let me know in the comments that you tried it or not and whether you liked it or not. Stay tuned for more recipes. Bye!